So I can start with idea validation and go all the way to see if my product works well.
Absolutely. There's ways for user research to help you throughout that process.
Okay, so we talked about user research, but what does a designer do?
Well, if you're an interaction designer like me, you're going to spend a lot of time grappling with tasks. You're going to think about, well, what are all of the different tasks that the user is going to perform inside of this product? And for every given task that you have, you're going to try to dive in and just try to figure out like that sequence of an interactions that the user is going to have. And sometimes you can think about that like a dialogue. You can think about, well, if the user does X, the system's going to do Y, and then the user is going to come back and do Z. You'll kind of go through that, and you'll start by just kind of shaping one of those, but then you'll kind of go broader and broader. You'll think about all the other variants of that same task. So what if the user does, you know, W instead of Y?
Right.
And how does the system respond to that? And that'll help you just kind of understand what some of the constraints are and what some of the things you need to account for in the design. And then from there, you go kind of bigger and bigger. You think about what the next task is, and you start to kind of chain those together in interesting ways. You'll start to see things that are kind of commonalities, tasks that are similar or sometimes even the same to each other that are kind of good opportunities, and also things that are really unique. You know, particular tasks that have these very one-off set of interactions that don't occur elsewhere.
So I have to map every interaction?
Well, either you're going to map them all or the user is going to kind of have to create their own map. So trying to anticipate as many of those interactions as you can is going to make it easier for the user to kind of follow through on those goals inside your product.